I go to the 24 question. Question number 24. Boat has a length of 10 meters. It is at a distance of 40 meters from the bank of the lake. So situation is given like this. So that is, this is the a tower of some particular height. The height of the tower is given to you as 32 meters. And from the foot of the tower, at a distance of 40 meters, we have a boat which is of length. Length of the boat is given to you as 10 meters. So this is a situation given to us. And particle is projected from the tower with some velocity, 10 meters per second, and at an angle 37 degrees with the horizontal. So what should be the velocity of the boat towards the bank? So velocity of the boat towards the bank, let me assume as V. Towards the boat, this is the velocity of the boat towards the bank. So that ball falls into the boat. So actually here, there are two extreme conditions are there, because boat length also comes into the play. So for that, let me assume V velocity, बाद में वो velocity maximum क्या होगा, minimum क्या होगा, वो सभी find out कर लेकर में. So first, let me resolve the projectile velocity into components. That is, by keeping the boat at rest. So मैंने assume boat at rest means that I try to solve the problem with respect to the observer on the boat. With respect to the observer on the boat, I try to write it so that boat can be assumed at rest, and boat velocity will be given to the projectile in reverse direction. Boat is towards the left, so projectile ko maine a velocity diya in the reverse direction. So this will be V, and already projectile is having one component, that is 10 cos 37 along the horizontal direction and 10 sin 37 along the vertically downward direction. So with respect to boat observer, with respect to boat observer, x component of velocity of the particle is, projectile x component will be 10 cos 37 plus V, that is 8 plus V. Boat observer का रेस्पेक्ट में, एंड y डायरेक्शन में तो कोई कंपोनेंट नहीं है, सो y कंपोनेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी विल बी एज इट इज 10 sin 37 व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 6 मीटर्स पर सेकंड वेलोसिटी इज देयर इन द y डायरेक्शन. सो y कंपोनेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी, फ्रॉम द y कंपोनेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी आई कैन बी एबल टू फाइंड आउट टाइम टेकन बाय द प्रोजेक्टाइल टू रीच टू द बोट. सो टाइम टेकन बाय द projectile to reach the boat can be find out by using the formula SY, y component of displacement, UY into T plus half AY into T square. Y component of displacement is the height of the tower. Downward when a positive layer of plus 32. Y component of velocity will be 6 OB positive and into T plus half acceleration due to gravity 10 T square. If I simplify this one to get the time taken by the projectile to reach to the ground. So can anyone please reply to me how much time projectile will take to reach to the ground? Simplify करके आंसर देने में थोड़ा सा रेस्पॉन्स देना पड़ेगा.
Sir, 2 seconds.
Okay, simplify कर लिया आपने. The time is coming out to be 2 seconds. So this projectile will reach to the ground after 2 seconds. So this is the time taken by the projectile to reach to the boat, and in this interval, if I see, particle is entering at the left end of the boat. So horizontal displacement is 40 meters. And other extreme end, if I see B, horizontal displacement of the projectile will be 50 meters. If it is going towards the other extreme end. So least horizontal displacement is 40, which is horizontal component of displacement is 40. Horizontal component of velocity, मैंने equation है, Sx equation में use कर रहा हूँ मैंने, ux into t plus half axt square. So horizontal component of displacement is 40 minimum, and a minimum horizontal component of velocity 8 plus v. Here v is a minimum velocity into time is 2 seconds. So you can easily simplify that. Minimum velocity of the particle will be 12 meters per second. And similar equation, same equation मैंने maximum velocity का भी use कर लेता हूँ. Maximum velocity horizontal component of displacement is 50, which is 8 plus v max into t. T is 2 seconds in this. So this will be 25 minus 8 maximum velocity will be. So that will be v max is 17 meters per second will be the maximum velocity. Next. So 24th one is done. Ask me the next one. So किसी का कोई doubt है इसमें? 24th one में किसी का doubt है?
Sir, can you explain this one again?
मैंने actually problem solve कर लिया boat observer का respect में. Boat observer को rest पे रख दिया मैंने. Boat observer, boat को rest पे रख के boat velocity which is towards the left side is given to the projectile in the right direction. Relative concept use करके मैंने ये projectile को दिया and projectile already having some velocity of 8 meters per second along the horizontal direction.
Yes sir.
So horizontal component of velocity of the projectile is 8 plus v and vertical component of velocity of the projectile is 6. So if I simplify that time, how much time projectile will come to the boat? By writing SY equation, I'm getting this as 2 seconds. And in the same interval, if it is entering at the left extreme mein hai toh 40 meters horizontal displacement hoga. If it is at the right extreme, and 50 meters horizontal displacement hoga. And when it is a left extreme and 40 meters horizontal displacement, velocity will be minimum. Okay, sir. And 50 right extreme horizontal displacement, then in that case maximum velocity. Okay, mere problem?
No, sir.
Boat ka velocity meters per second hona chahiye, and maximum 17 meters per second hona chahiye. ये दोनों के बीच में कोई भी वेलोसिटी होगा तो चलेगा बट इफ वेलोसिटी इज लेस देन दैट मोर देन दैट देन इट विल बी नो आप गलत सोच रहे एक्चुअली लेफ्ट एक्सट्रीम सम स्टूडेंट्स आर आस्किंग 40 एंड नो एक्चुअली लेफ्ट एक्सट्रीम ऑफ द बोट इटसेल्फ इज 40 लेफ्ट एक्सट्रीम ऑफ द बोट इटसेल्फ इज 40 सेंटीमीटर्स फ्रॉम द फुट ऑफ द टावर सपोज आपने सपोज दिस इज द फुट ऑफ द टावर मान लो सपोज आपका बोट ए से है तो this is if it is this one is 40 meters then I have to take it as 40 minus 30 but the problem itself is given this itself is 40 this itself is 40 meters here left extreme distance itself is 40 okay ma'am next doubt I'm waiting for your next doubt
sir 23
थोड़ा सा इन्वॉल्व होना हाँ पूछना समवन इज आस्किंग मी सम डाउट 20
क्वेश्चन नंबर 26
26th वन डायरेक्टली क्वेश्चन नंबर 26 सो समवन इज आस्किंग 25 आल्सो मैं 25 में आ जाता हूं बाय दैट टाइम यू try to solve your from your side 26th also. So 25 complete karne ka aa jata hai also. Two particles A and B are projected simultaneously from the tower 1 and 2. So ये सभी problems हैं. Projectile का बहुत अच्छा examples है. Previous one also and now this one also. It is given that two towers. One is A and you are projecting the particle with a velocity upward direction at an angle 53 degrees with the horizontal. U velocity se project kar liya maan. And another particle is projected from the another tower B and which is projected with a velocity say for example B and which is projected at an angle 37 degrees as shown in the figure and U is given to you already 5 meters per second and B respectively B is the unknown. If both the particles collides in the mid-air after 2 seconds then find the value of horizontal distance S of the point of collision from the tower 2. So these two towers dono ka beech mein separation diya unhone 15 meters. So let me see the situation how it will be. This projectile will be following a parabolic path and it will go like this. Second one will follow a parabolic path and it will go like this. So that these two will be colliding at this position. On low, they are colliding from the second tower. From the second tower, they are colliding at a distance S. And this is the first two tower. So, what is S they are asking in the question? One information problem is now, it is a two-dimension problem. So, we need to resolve all the known velocities and accelerations into components. So, let me write the X and Y components of velocity of projection from the tower A. That is U cos 53. And Y component of velocity is in the upward direction. And U sin 53. Similar way, from the tower B, horizontal component is V cos 37, and vertically downward component is V sin 37. V sin 37 is given. So, in this situation, one information already they have given that they all meet, both will meet after 2 seconds. So, in these 2 seconds' time, horizontal displacement of the particle from the tower A. So, from tower A, tower 1, if I write it, horizontal displacement. I try to use the equation
U sin theta by 2G.
U cos 53, na, horizontal component. U cos 53, horizontal component. So, U cos 53. Into 2 seconds. And from the second tower also, if I see the horizontal component of displacement from second tower, from the tower 2, can anyone give that what is the horizontal component of displacement in 2 seconds? In 2 seconds, what is the horizontal component of displacement? Koi de sakta hai kya answer? What is the horizontal component of displacement from the tower 2? B cos
37 into 2.
2 seconds. And ye dono ka sum. Horizontal displacement from the tower 1, SX1, let me assume. Horizontal distance from the tower 2, SX2, which is they are calling it as S. Ye dono ka sum aapne dekh liya to question mein diya 15 meters. So, U cos 53 into T, 2 seconds. Plus V cos 37 into 2 seconds, दोनों का सम है 15 meters का equal हो गया question में. So U is given to you 5 cos 37, that is 3 by 5 into 5, so it is 3 into 2, plus V cos 37 is 4 by 5 into 2, is equal to 15 meters. So from this, I'm expecting the answer that what is the value? find out the v value. V value second tower se velocity mil jata hai. Second tower se v value mil gaya to
20.
Ye equation mein submit kar. V is 20. If you verify that, kuch galat lag raha hai. V 20 nahi. Check kar le ek baar.
सर हमें SX2 फाइंड करना है ना.
SX2 फाइंड करना है. फर्स्ट वेलोसिटी मिल जाता है इधर से, इसके बाद SX2 फाइंड कर सकते हैं. दैट इज यस. V कितने आ रहे हैं?
5
आ रहा है क्या? चेक कर लेता हूं मैंने एक बार. 6 प्लस 8 वी बाई 5 इज 15. तो 8 वी बाई 5 बाई 8 आ रहा है. ये भी आप फाइनल आंसर दे रहे हैं. 45 बाई 8. सो SX2 फाइंड आउट करना है हमने. 45 by 8 cos 37. 45 by 8 cos 37. मैं देखता हूँ, मैंने equation में देख लेता हूँ इधर. 45 by 8 cos 37 will be 3 by 5 into 2. तो आप आंसर दे सकते हैं इसमें. cos 37 4 by 5. तो ये कैंसिल होगा. 9 मीटर्स इज द आंसर. तो ये इधर से 9 मीटर्स ए एंड से, एंड ए एंड से 6 मीटर्स. एनी अदर डाउट इन दिस? एनी अदर डाउट? पूछना मैं स्पीड का डाउट. सो 26 टू 1. ओके फाइन. नेक्स्ट बोर्ड में आ रहा. 26 क्वेश्चन. सम स्टूडेंट्स आर आस्किंग 26 क्वेश्चन एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज बेस्ड ऑन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ वर्क एनर्जी थ्योरम. वर्क एनर्जी थ्योरम सेज दैट वर्क डन बाय ऑल द फोर्सेस, whatever the forces involved in the problem, ये सभी का work done होगा. Change in kinetic energy, ये आप सभी को पता है, this is the work energy theorem. So it is based on that only. But here we have some difficulty that work done by the external agent who is lifting the body from the right end to the left end. Initially, body is at the right end. It is at the P location. And now you are lifting this and placing at the S location. So, for that, external agent has to do some work. So, work done by the external agent. Plus, work done by the friction force. Plus, work done by the gravity. मैं सभी forces लिख देता हूँ इसमें. बाद में चेक करेंगे कौन सा फोर्स जीरो होगा. वर्क डन बाय द नॉर्मल व्हिच इज इक्वल टू चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी K2 माइनस K1. देन ऑब्वियस फोर्सेस वर्क डन आपको पता है. नॉर्मल फोर्स वर्क डन विल बी जीरो बिकॉज ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट एंड नॉर्मल फोर्स आर ऑलवेज परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर. तो नॉर्मल फोर्स कोई भी इंस्टेंट में आप नॉर्मल फोर्स देख लिया तो डिस्करेक्ट हो गया वो. सो डिस्प्लेसमेंट वर्क डन बाय ऑल द फोर्सेस इक्वल टू चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी. सो वर्क डन बाय द नॉर्मल फोर्स इसमें जीरो होता है. because they are perpendicular to each other. Displacement and the normal force are perpendicular to each other always. P end से Q end में body लेके जा रहा है. Now other one is work done by gravity. If I see that, can anyone give me that? What is the work done by the gravity if I lift the body from the position A to position B? कितने होगा gravity का work?
Sorry, your screen is not visible.
Screen is not visible.
Sir, it is visible.
Visible. Okay. So gravity का work done कितने होगा इसमें? Gravity work done कितने होगा? Gravity का work done very good. Gravity का work done will be zero because if you lift the body from P position to Q position, same horizontal level पे body होगा. So height rise or height fallen by the body is zero. So gravity work done zero होगा इसमें. So next one is the problem with us with this is problem is a friction force work done find out करना. Friction force कितना work करता है? That you need to find out that. This one is the challenging part of the question. What is the challenge in this? That for that, I try to explain this in a different way. Say for example, we have some inclined surface. We have some inclined surface, say say inclined surface, say hill station, something like that. Say inclined surface. And you are lifting the body from the bottom of the inclined surface to the top of the inclined surface, whose projection length is L. A length L ka equal. Base length is L. Now, if there is a friction between the block and the surface, whose friction coefficient is mu, while you are lifting the body from the bottommost point to the topmost point, if I take one elemental part of the inclined surface, this is the elemental part of the inclined surface, and this elemental part of the inclined surface, when I have which enlarged view, may draw karne to ds, let me assume elemental part, and over this elemental part, if I move the body from the bottom to top, how much is done by the friction? That work done will be W. ध्यान से देखना, थोड़ा सा difficult part है ये. Difficult part है, थोड़ा सा ध्यान से देखना. dW will be friction force mu mg cos theta. Displacement is ds. And ये दोनों का बीच में angle 180 degrees होगा, because friction backward direction में act होता है. And displacement upward direction में 180 degrees का angle दोनों का बीच में होता है. If I need what is that? You want me to draw again?
Sir, screen went.
So if I see the
yes, I'll draw again.
Okay. So, inclined surface from bottom to top. So, मैंने small part ले लिया ds and इसका enlarged view draw कर लेता हूँ मैं. ds bottom to top. Angle is theta. So that work done by the friction force dw. So dw कितने का equal होगा? Minus mu mg cos theta into ds. So total work done by the friction, if I want to find out, that is integration. Mu is constant, mg is constant, and ds cos theta. What is actually ds cos theta? If I see that, this is ds length. And ds cos theta is the base portion length. ये d is cos theta equal होता है, ये base portion है, means इधर से एक vertical line draw कर लिया, इधर से एक vertical line draw कर लिया, this will be ds cos theta, which is dl, base length, so this will be minus mu mg, integration of ds cos theta will be dl, and integration of dl will be total base length, total base length, इधर से इधर तक integration of dl will be total base length, that is l. So this is the work done by the friction in the problem. So now, if I go to the work energy theorem, work done by the gravity plus work done by the normal plus work done by the friction plus work done by the external agent, which is equal to change in kinetic energy, हमने लिख दिया. तो इसमें gravity work done आपने बोला zero, normal force work done zero, kinetic energy change minimum work के लिए जीरो कैनेटिक एनर्जी, इधर से हमने पी पॉइंट से क्यू पॉइंट तक लेके जा रहे हैं ऑलमोस्ट विदाउट एनी चेंज इन द कैनेटिक एनर्जी, के टू माइनस के वन इज जीरो, देन वर्क डन बाय द एक्सटर्नल एजेंट इज इक्वल टू नेगेटिव ऑफ वर्क डन बाय द फ्रिक्शन. नो यू सी बिलो
सर हाउ ग्रेविटी इज स्टिल जीरो,
एक बार देख के, बिकॉज द हाइट राइज्ड बाय द बॉडी इज जीरो, बिकॉज आपने इधर से इधर तक नेगेटिव कर दिया ग्रेविटी ने एंड वापस
सर योर वॉइस इज लैगिंग,
तो पॉजिटिव वर्क कर लिया, मे बी दिस विल बी द लास्ट क्लास, ना मैनेज कर लो थोड़ा सा, नेक्स्ट क्लास दिस विल बी माय लास्ट क्लास, सम विल ट्राई टू मैनेज, आई हैव सम नेटवर्क इश्यूज हियर, सो सर विल कंटिन्यू नेक्स्ट क्लास, आपका मैनेज करना है सम. So work done by the friction force, gravity work done zero हो गया, friction work done, friction work done कितने का equal हो गया, ये formula देखते हैं, formula देख के किसी ने, any one of you please tell me that what is the work done by the friction in our situation, ये case में कितने का
equal, minus mu mg 2r,
yes, work done by the friction will be minus mu mg into 2r base length will be, either say that. So I put this value in this formula, work done by the external agent is already minus sign is there in the formula, and minus mu mg into 2r ri, so external agent of work done over mu times mg into I equal, okay ma'am. Next one, सेंड मी द नेक्स्ट डाउट, अच्छा क्वेश्चन है, बहुत बार ऐसे क्वेश्चंस बहुत बार आता है वर्क एनर्जी थ्योरम में, दिस राइट पार्ट, राइट साइड पार्ट में भी सर ने क्लास में डिस्कस कर लिया होगा, ये एम आई राइट, एम आई राइट, हो गया नहीं हो,
यस सर,
हां नेक्स्ट डाउट, सेंड मी द नेक्स्ट डाउट. Next one, what is the next one?
Sir, can you show the previous page, please? For once, sometime.
Just a minute, just a minute. Yes. बीच में मैंने थोड़ा सा roughly draw कर लिया, चलेगा ना? Manage करेंगे? समझ में आ रहा है?
Yes, sir. It's okay.
Yes, sir.
इवन इरिडो में भी ऐसे क्वेश्चंस होता है ये कांसेप्ट का रिलेटेड, बाद में भी बहुत बार आता है ऐसे क्वेश्चंस. ओके नेक्स्ट वन, सो आई एम गोइंग टू द नेक्स्ट डाउट आफ्टर 26, प्लीज फॉरवर्ड द नेक्स्ट डाउट, नेक्स्ट डाउट 28, सम स्टूडेंट्स आर सेंडिंग, केतन 28, okay, so what is the 28th question, quarter disc of mass m and radius r, so first the problem is a formula based, but a slight variation from the formula base. That is a, this is the quarter disk which is given to us. And this quarter disk of radius r is hinged at the center and is free to rotate about an axis passing through the plane of the disk and passing the center. Okay, fine. Angular frequency means that a system unhone aise le liya, a quarter disk ko maine aise tilt karke idhar draw kar raha hu again wapas, and this angle is given as 90 degrees, and a axis ka respect mein this body is allowed to oscillate. Means that aise oscillate ho raha hoga plane, board plane, vertical direction, vertical plane mein oscillate ho raha hai. Horizontal axis is passing through the center. This is the axis of rotation. So actually, this is the problem of a pendulum. So you must read about a physical pendulum. Time period of the physical pendulum is 2 pi under root of I about the given axis upon mgd. Can anyone give me what is the d here? What is d? Anyone? Can anyone please reply to me? What is d here? Distance from the hinge to axis to COM of the system. So somewhere you have COM here for this system. So that axis is UM ka beech mein distance hai, that is G. So target of the question is, one is I about the axis and other one is D. This is the moment of inertia about the axis. These two points, if I am able to find out, so a problem ho gaya. So I about the axis, M and R radius of the disk, if it is a quarter disk also, its moment of inertia about this axis. What is the answer? What is the moment of inertia about this axis? What is the moment of inertia? रिप्लाई करना है ये सिस्टम का मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया क्या? हेलो, सो दैट इज एम आर स्क्वायर बाय टू. यस, वेरी गुड, करेक्ट. एम आर स्क्वायर बाय टू. ये सिस्टम ए एक्सिस का रेस्पेक्ट में मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया एम आर स्क्वायर बाय टू का इक्वल होगा. रिजिड बॉडी डायनेमिक्स का कॉन्सेप्ट है. Now, another thing is, where is COM? What is its COM coordinates will be? Maine first to figure mein aa raha hu, this is the COM coordinates. This is COM. Let me assume its y coordinate of the COM. X coordinate, let me assume x. And y coordinate, let me assume as y. Quarter disk COM find out karna thoda sa difficult hai. As compared to semicircular disk. Semicircular disk आपने पढ़ लिया होगा. Semicircular disk का तो COM you can easily find out. So मैंने another quarter disk ले लेता हूँ of M mass and R radius, and its coordinates of COM is minus x comma y. Y तो same होगा, उनका height same होगा. तो फर्स्ट क्वार्टर डिस्क से मैंने इमेजिन कर रहा हूं अनदर क्वार्टर डिस्क, सो दैट सेमी सर्कुलर डिस्क बन जाएगा. तो सेमी सर्कुलर डिस्क बन गया, तो वाई सी ओ एम ऑफ द सेमी सर्कुलर डिस्क एम वन वाई वन प्लस एम टू वाई टू अपॉन एम वन प्लस एम टू. सो वाई सी ओ एम ऑफ द सेमी सर्कुलर डिस्क इज 4r by 3 pi. एम वन इज एम y plus m2 is also m, y upon m1 plus m2 is 2m. So I get y quad of this will be 4 r by 3 pi. So this is the y coordinate of COM, which is a 4 r by 3 pi. This is 4 r by 3 pi y coordinate hoga. Y coordinate value 4 r by 3 pi hoga. But humko idhar se distance chahiye. Axis se, axis is, let me assume A. A se C tak distance chahiye. A se B tak distance to 4 r by 3 pi aa gaya. But A se C tak distance chahiye. So AC will be, that is 4 r by 3 pi root 2 ka equal hoga, because the angle 45 degrees hai. So C one distance from axis, this is C distance, which is D, 4 r by 3 pi into root. So that you can put it, these two terms you can put it into this formula. And omega is 2 by D. Omega is 2 by D. So here, from this calculation, you see that how to find the COM of the quantities. Kaise find out the quantities ka COM, kaise find out the logic is involved here. तो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन भेजना है, सेंड मी द नेक्स्ट. थर्टी फोर बीच में कोई डाउट नहीं है क्या? 34 में जा सकता हूं मैं डायरेक्टली? ओके, 34 में जा रहा हूं मैं. कभी बाद में डाउट है तो पूछ सकते हैं, मैं टाइम दे दूंगा आपको. 34. सो व्हाट इज दिस क्वेश्चन इज पेंडुलम टाइम पीरियड. इट इज पेंडुलम हैज अ टाइम पीरियड फॉर स्मॉल ऑसिलेशंस. An obstacle is placed directly beneath the pivot so that only the lower one quarter of the string can allow as a pendulum of when it swings to the left of its okay position. Okay, fine. So, okay, question samajh mein aa gaya mujhe. Pendulum is released from the rest at a certain point A. Find the time taken to return to the same point. Find the value of N. Okay, fine. तो अभी आप सभी ने क्वेश्चन, सो लैंग्वेज ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इज लाइक दिस. लैंग्वेज ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, देयर इज अ वॉल ऑफ हाइट 3L/4 एंड दिस इज द पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग एंड स्ट्रिंग हैज अ लेंथ L. नाउ if you release at this position, after some time obviously the body will be coming to this position. After some time, 1/4 of the time period, it will be coming to this position. But here, because of the wall, this portion of the string is not able to move. So effectively left side aapka pendulum aise move लेफ्ट पोर्शन के लिए ये पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन होगा. पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन लेफ्ट पोर्शन के लिए एंड राइट पोर्शन के लिए ये पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन होगा. पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन ये होगा. सो देन इफ इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम ए, दैट इज द राइट एक्सट्रीम टू मी and to the B left extreme and वापस again mean पे आ जाता है and again it is going to the right extreme. Then you can see here during the motion at the right extreme side, it will be oscillating with a string length of L. And during the motion at the left extreme end, it is oscillating with a effective length of the string is L by 4. Because now a point of suspension of L. So L by 4. So right gear is pendulum length and left gear is pendulum length. Right gear is L, left gear to L by 4. Okay. So time period of any pendulum, basic formula, 2 pi under root of L length of the pendulum by G. Right side के लिए time period है, total time period लिख रहा हूँ right side के लिए, 2 pi into under root of L by G. Left side के लिए time period है, 2 pi into under root of L by 2 G. Time period formula लिख दिया, but right side it will spend a time of half of the time period only, because इधर से mean by and means a wapas extreme t by 4. So right side time it is spending will be t by 4, sorry, t 1 by 2, and left side it is spending time will be t 2 by 2. That is the total time. So t 1 by 2, that is 2 pi into under root of L by G. T 2 by 2, so 2 pi 2 cancel hoga isme, plus pi bachega isme. And right, T2 by 2 will be pi into under root of L by 2, L by 4 is L by 4 upon G. So this will be the total time. Next doubt is send your doubts. Next doubt. 32, 35 and 36. The 32 में आने दो. 32 complete कर लेता हूँ. आप note कर लिया क्या previous one? समझ में आ गया आपका? हेलो हाँ ओके 32 में आ रहा हूँ मैं ओके बाय सो अ स्मॉल ब्लॉक ऑफ मास एम इज इनिशियली एट द लोएस्ट पोजीशन ऑफ अ वर्टिकल फिक्स्ड सिलिंड्रिकल सरफेस हुज इनर सरफेस इज स्मूथ एट द लोएस्ट पोजीशन ब्लॉक इज गिवन as much as speed so that it can just complete the vertical circular motion. The magnitude of acceleration of at the position A and at the highest position B respectively are A1 and A2. Okay, fine. So this question is the application of vertical circular motion. So let me go with the situation. What is there? Lowermost position, I apply bottommost position. You must have given a velocity root 5 g r velocity here, where r is the radius of this circuit, vertical circuit. And at topmost point, which is B, and at the B position, you know very well that it has a velocity of root gl. And at this position, that is A position, it has a velocity of, I'm waiting for your answer, anyone. I'm waiting for your
answer.
What is the velocity of A? Root 3 gr. Velocity of A position. Very good. Velocity at B and velocity at A. So now, what is the first question they have asked you? Magnitude of acceleration at A. So I'll be solving that at A first. I'll be attempting now. At A, what is the situation? At A, any body which is moving in a circular path in general, you know very well that two accelerations will be there. One is the radial acceleration directed towards the center. Directed towards the center, which is equal to v square by r. Which is v at this instant is root 3 gr. Energy conservation se derive kar liya hoga aapne. So 3 gr. V square hai to 3 gr upon r, which is 3 g. And tangential acceleration is ye instant pe gravitational force tangential direction mein hota hai. This is the tangential direction. This direction is the tangential direction. And this is the radial direction. So along the tangential direction, if it is a smooth surface, at this instant only gravitational force is there. So gravitational force is mg upon mass of the body is m. So g it is. And these two are perpendicular to each other. Magnitude of acceleration will be under root of 3g square plus g square. That is g root 10. Acceleration of a position. That is what we have done at the position A. Next, I go to the position B. This is the position B. At the position B, radial acceleration directed towards the center. A direction mein radial acceleration hoga, which is equal to V square by R, where V is root GL. So V square by R, GL by root GR. So GR by R, which is equal to G. And in tangential direction, mein koi acceleration nahi hoga. This is the tangential direction. For B position, this is the tangential direction. And there are no forces along this direction. Normal and gravity vertical direction mein hoga. So tangential direction mein koi force nahi, koi acceleration bhi nahi. So net will be simply G ka equal hoga. Then they are expecting that A1 square magnitude. A1 square minus A2 square. A1 square is 10G. Minus A2 square is 10G square. This is the rule. Upon G square they are expecting the answer. So you get the answer as 9. You can really check the answer. What is done? Hello? Thirty-two is done. Isn't it doubt pucha? Aapko clear ho gaya wo? Okay. Next doubt. Go to the next doubt. आप नोट नहीं किए एंड दिस इज वन मोर गुड क्वेश्चन दैट रिलेटेड टू टेंजेंशियल एक्सेलरेशन एंड द रेडियल एक्सेलरेशन आंसर आई एम गोइंग टू द नेक्स्ट वन सो आई एम वेटिंग फॉर योर आंसर क्वेश्चंस ओके नेक्स्ट डाउट इज Please send me your next doubts. Okay. Some students are asking some more also. Maybe if you have, you can ask. Any other doubt is there? 35. Next to 35. Appo, what is the topic going on in your regular classes? Normally, classes mein topic kya ho raha
hai? Sir, last class mein SHM complete kiya tha.
Aap 11th ka bachche hai, 12th ka bachche hai? आप 12th का है ना?
हाँ सर.
ओके, देन SHM आपको 11th में नहीं हुआ. ओके, 12th
क्या रिवाइज कर रहे? एक बैच का बचा था, एक बैच का कंप्लीट हुआ था.
ओके ओके, मेबी. हाँ 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 हाँ. तो ओके, इसके बाद 12th का कौन सा टॉपिक स्टार्ट हो गया
सर? अभी करेंगे सर स्टार्ट.
ओके ओके, मेबी ज्योमेट्रिक टॉपिक स्टार्ट होने वाला है क्या? ओके, मेबी आपको आइडिया नहीं होंगे कौन सा होगा. ओके, सो आई एम गोइंग टू द 35th क्वेश्चन. वेलोसिटी एंड एक्सेलरेशन वेक्टर्स ऑफ ए पार्टिकल. Velocity of the particle is given, which is 2i. And acceleration is given to you as 2i plus 4j. Then, if I go to the concept of radius of curvature, circular motion, radius of curvature concept, if I see that, radius of curvature is square of the speed upon component of acceleration perpendicular to the velocity. This is the speed of the particle. This is just the speed, magnitude of velocity. Magnitude of velocity or the speed. And a perpendicular is the perpendicular component of acceleration. Perpendicular to whom? Perpendicular to the velocity. Perpendicular component to velocity. So what is the perpendicular component to velocity here? That is a perpendicular is 4. And what is the magnitude of velocity will be? That is magnitude of velocity will be 2. So the radius of curvature, if I try to write it here, square of the speed upon component of acceleration perpendicular to that. That is 1 meter will be the radius of curvature of the particle at that instant. Radius of curvature at that instant. Okay, ma'am. Send me your next route if it is there. Is it? Is there any other doubt? Okay. So, aapka koi doubt nahi hai, to main.
Sir. Sir, question number 33.
Question number 33. Question number 33. A small ball on a frictionless horizontal surface moves towards the right with a velocity of 15 meters per second. So this is the situation given to you. Now in this situation, the sphere is given some velocity v in this direction, mass. What is that velocity? 15 meters per second. Now it collides with the wall and returns back to continue to and fro motion. The average speed first to and fro motion of the ball is 10 meters per second. So data apne adjust karna chahiye. Isme average speed for the first to and fro motion is 10 meters per second. Means that if it is starting from A and it is going along the straight line A se jaake, A point mein hit karke, वापस अगेन ए पोजीशन में आ गया, दैट इंटरवल ए से बी तक, ए टू बी अगेन टू द पोजीशन ए, दिस इंटरवल एवरेज स्पीड इज गिवन टू यू एज 10 मीटर्स पर सेकंड. हमने बेसिक स्टिक करेंगे तो एवरेज स्पीड का बेसिक फॉर्मूला क्या है? average speed is total distance traveled upon total time taken. आप सभी को पता है. तो always actually in physics you have to stick to the basics only, fundamentals only you have to stick, so that most of the questions can be done. Fundamentals if you stick, at least minimum level questions can be done if you stick to the fundamental. Let me assume A से B तक distance d है in one complete to and fro motion. One complete to and fro motion, it will be traveling at distance of 2d. Total distance traveled by the body will be 2d, and time taken will be A से B तक time है. It is going with a speed of distance is d A से B तक, and it is having the speed of 15 meters per second. And B से वापस A position में आ गया, वो भी d distance ही travel कर रहा है, but its speed will be 15 times of A. What I want to say here, after collision with B, its speed becomes 15 times of A, where A is the coefficient of restitution. Coefficient of restitution it is. So after colliding with the wall, its speed becomes 15 times of E. So 15 times of E speed se ye return aa jata hai ye position mein. That is T2 time interval. Then ye formula mein maine submit kar liya to delta average speed is 10 meters per second. Total distance is 2D upon T1 time is D upon 15. T2 time is D upon 15 E. So you can nicely simplify this to get the value of E, I think. Can it be done? Ho jata hai kya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next doubt. So anyway, bahut kam time bacha. So I cannot start any other meeting also. So please, you ask me one, two more doubts are there in this. Are anything missing in the paper one? You ask me. So that I can wind up. So maybe next class aapko sir ne start karenge freshly. Next doubt. Any other doubt? So can I wind up this? Okay. One more doubt is there. No other time. So then I try to give you one problem, one two problem I try to give you a little bit challenging problems. Okay, again question aa raha hai abhi 36. Remind me that I'll give you one two good questions. So try karna apne some students are asking 36 abhi try kar lo ho gaya. So मैंने कुछ अच्छा क्वेश्चन आपको दे देता हूँ. वेट करना है जस्ट अ मिनट, जस्ट अ मिनट, जस्ट अ मिनट. वन टू क्वेश्चन आई विल गिव यू सो दैट प्लीज वेट. थोड़ा सा चैलेंजिंग क्वेश्चन है मेरे पास एक दो, आपको थोड़ा सा एनालाइज करने के लिए थोड़ा सा वे ऑफ थिंकिंग चेंज. एक दो क्वेश्चन आपको दे दूंगा. You'll find it very good questions. Like these questions are very good. I feel maybe आपको भी अच्छा लगेगा. But it will be time taking. Just take it as a additional free time work. So that आपको अच्छा होगा ये क्वेश्चन से. आई बी सेंडिंग टू यू.
आर यू सेंड इट द ऑन ग्रुप.
जस्ट वेट कर लो ना, ये ज्यादा टाइम नहीं हो गया मैंने. ये दोनों क्वेश्चन आपके हैं. Please note it down this question. सिने आंसर दे सकते हैं तो दे सकते हैं. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सेकंड क्वेश्चन का अभी आंसर तो लिख दिया मैंने. आइडिया देना है तो सेकंड क्वेश्चन का आइडिया दे दो, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन का आंसर भी दे सकते हैं.
सर कैन यू ज़ूम द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन प्लीज.
ओके five identical bricks each of length l are arranged as shown in the figure. Find the maximum value of x so that system is in equilibrium. Five identical bricks each of length l are arranged as shown in the figure. Find the maximum value of x so that system is in equilibrium. That is the first one, and you can see the second one also. Second one also, should I read it? Distance, x is the distance they are asking. X is the distance they are asking. So from my side, I have completed comfortably x paper one and paper two. Maybe thoda sa connection problems are little bit issues, network issues from my side. Anyway, sir will be taking next class. Okay, so I still ask now. Note कर लिया आपने ये? और इसका इधर कर लिया. And